वेलकम इन राठौड़ क्लासेस। माई सेल्फ राठौड़ नरेंद्र माणिक राव फ्रॉम जय जवान जय किसान बॉयज मिलिट्री स्कूल सोलापुर। फ्रेंड्स वेलकम टू यू ऑल इन ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द थर्ड लेक्चर ऑफ द लेसन Life Processes in Living Organism Part 2 from Class 10 Science and Technology. In previous video, we had discussed about characters of asexual reproduction, asexual reproduction in unicellular organism, binary fission and axis of fission, budding. And today we are going to discuss about asexual reproduction in multicellular organism, fragmentation, regeneration, budding, vegetative propagation, spore formation. So we start asexual reproduction in multicellular organism. As like the process of asexual reproduction takes place in unicellular organism, as like the process of asexual reproduction is also takes place in multicellular organism. Means, in short, the single parent can produce the new individual by the process of asexual reproduction in multicellular organism also, and this process of reproduction is takes place by the process fragmentation. Fragment means part. Fragmentation, from the part of the body, all body of an organism is developed. That is says to be the fragmentation. Here, fragmentation is a asexual reproduction which occur in multicellular organism. In this type reproduction, the body of parent organism break up into many fragments, means in a many pieces, and each fragment start to live as an independent new organism, and this type of reproduction is takes place in algae like Spirogyra and sponge like Cycon. Here, whenever or when the organism obtain the plenty of food and water, what happen? Its filaments grow up rapidly and break up into many small fragmentation. In simple, what we say, whenever there is a plenty of food and water are available to the Spirogyra, its filaments grow up rapidly, means very fast, and break up into many small fragments, and each fragment start to live independently as new Spirogyra fiber. And if the body of Cycon breaks up accidentally into many fragments, each fragment or each part developed into new Cycon. Here the Spirogyra, this one is the Spirogyra, and when this Spirogyra obtain plenty of food and water, the filaments of that Spirogyra grow rapidly and breaks. And what happen after breaking? This fragment is grown independently and develop a new spirochira fiber as like same in a cyclone. When it breaks into many pieces, every piece of cyclone grows an independent individual. It is said to be the fragmentation. Then next one, process of asexual reproduction is regeneration. Re means what? Again. Generation means what? Development. The part of body is redeveloped in this process. So the process of reproduction in this, the part of body is redeveloped is said to be the regeneration. And we all well know that the wall lizard breaks up and discards some part of its tail in emergency. And this discarded, detached, broken part of the tail of wall lizard regenerate again after some period. It is a well-known example we have to see. In our home, if we see or if we observe by accident or by in an emergency, wall lizards cuts his tails, and the tail which is degenerate, which is discard or breaks, that tails grow again after few period. That is the example of regeneration, and this is a well known example of limited regeneration. And however, under certain example of limited condition, the animal named Planaria breaks up its body into two parts. As like wall lizard, here the Planaria is an animal who break up his body in a two parts, and every part of that body is regenerated, redeveloped into total body or full body. Each part of the body of a Planaria regenerates the remaining part of the body, and two new planarias are formed. This is called as regeneration. Here, if you see, this is the Planaria parent body. This Planaria break his body here in single part, here in same part. Means from head region and from tail region it's break, and from these both part the total body, this one head region and tail region, one and two different, two individual planarias are regenerated from head region and tail region. Means what? From the part of head which is degenerated, the part of tail and remaining part is degenerated, and from the tail and head total body of Planaria is regenerated, redeveloped. So in simple we say, from a degenerated part total body of the organism is regenerated, is regenerated or developed. From the part of the body, total body is regenerated. It is said to be the regeneration, and regeneration is the process of asexual reproduction in which total body of an organism is developed by a part of organism. Okay, then next one part or next one type of asexual reproduction takes place in a multicellular organism is an budding. The process of budding is takes place as like the process of budding takes place in a unicellular. Here also buds are came on the body, and that buds grow and detach from the parent body and live a individual life. Here the process of budding takes place in multicellular organism in animal named Hydra. In Hydra, under favorable and suitable condition at a specific part on its body, an outgrowth is formed by repeated division of regenerative cell of the body wall, and this outgrowth is nothing but a bud. Bud develops or grow progressively and form a small hydra, dermal layer and digestive cavity of the budding hydra continuously like the parent hydra, and the nutrition is supplied by the parent hydra during the process of development, and new developed hydra separate from parent hydra and start to lead an independent life, and when it grows up and become able to lead a independent life when it grows up. Here hydra, this one is the hydra, okay. On the body of hydra, small bud is came. This one is the bud, and this bud grows progressively from a small hydra, and this bud grows and increase in size, and from that bud the new hydra is produced. It is says to be the budding, means the bud on the parent hydra bud is came, that bud grows and all the parts of the body are diverted towards that bud, and when that bud is fully grown, that bud detaches from the parent body and grow fully and spent a independent life as like a parent hydra. Then the process of reproduction takes place in a plant like vegetative parts like stem, leaf and bud is called as vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation is the process of asexual reproduction which is takes place in higher plants or in a plants. Vegetative parts are present in plant, we generally know. The parts which are responsible for development of the plant, that parts are said to be the vegetative parts, like roots, like stem, like buds, like leaves or leaves. And the process of reproduction or the process of propagation is takes place by that vegetative parts, that is said to be the vegetative propagation. Here vegetative propagation in potato is takes place with the help of eyes present on the tuber or stem. We know on the body of potato we have to see some eyes, or it is said to be the buds, and that from that bud present on the potato, from that bud new potatoes are developed. Then in the same way, in bryophyllum, here is the bryophyllum, this process is takes place with the help of bud that are present on the leaf margin. The buds are present at the leaf margin of a leaf of bryophyllum, and new plant is grown from that bud. The plants like sugarcane, rose plants, the vegetative propagation occur with the help of buds present on the body. Here we know We planted a piece of sugarcane in our field, and we chosen a piece of the sugarcane on the piece. Eyes are there or birds are there. Only the part of the sugarcane is grown who have birds or eyes, and that part we chosen for the planting. In simple, in we practiced that in our garden or at home, we choose a part of branch of rose plant who have bird or eyes, and when we put it this in a pot, that grows. Means in simple, the sugarcane or rose plants, the vegetative propagations occur with the help of birds present on the body, and plant like carrots and radish perform the vegetative propagation with the help of roots. We know carrots and radish are grow inside the soil, under the soil, and these are the root plants, and from the roots new plants are developed from the roots. Means in simple, what we say, the process of propagation, the process of reproduction takes place by root, the process of propagation takes place by bird, the process of reproduction or the process of propagation takes place by leaf, the process of propagation takes place by stem. That all processes are takes place in the process of, it is says to be the vegetative propagation. In simple, the process of propagation takes place by stem, leaf, buds and roots. That process is says to be the vegetative propagation. And vegetative propagation is an important asexual reproduction takes place in multicellular organism. Here, spore formation. Spore means cell. Formation of cell and reproduce, that is says to be the spore formation. For that, one activity suggests to us, that is, take a piece of wet bread and keep it in a humid place. Fungus will grow on it within 2 or 3 days, and observe this under compound microscope and draw its diagram. Mucor like fungi have filament body. They have sporangia or sporangium, that is the filament body, and this is says to be the sporangia, and these sporangia have once the spores are formed, sporangium burst and spore are released here, and spore germinate in a moist and warm place, and new fungal colonies are formed. What happen when spores are formed in the sporangia? These sporangiums are burst, and when it burst, many cells are spread from the sporangia. They go and settle on the ground, and when they got a suitable condition, they germinate and form a colony of spores. Okay, students, here we stop.